Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're about to head to one of these four doors, actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, and we've uncovered them by straightening crosses in different rooms here and here, and then here and here. We found these are like through the little hidden walls by touching other, gravestones here, made a ringing sound, and I think that's what opened the secret wall here, unless it was already there, already able to get through. I'm not sure. There were buttons, I think, in this room, here and here, that opened these doors here and here, so pretty interesting stuff. And so we've got some more doors to go through. We've rested up and we're ready to fight stuff, which is probably going to happen any minute now. Another door. My god. How big is this dungeon? Finally, go through this door. Okay. Another one of these. Okay, we've got an alcove here and another one of these coffins here, which may contain a ghoul. Nelvin stops abruptly and says, "Unless I'm mistaken, the small button here on this coffin lid is part of some mechanism." Really? Maybe something for our thief to disarm? Let's just finish mapping out the room by going to the wall and just walking around so we have it accurately represented on our map here. I keep looking at these things. They look like frescoes, maybe? Some kind of artwork, ceremonial symbol, I don't know. And we've got, even though we're in a crypt, which you think would be underground, sometimes we see windows. Who knows? Maybe they're purely decorative, maybe they're not actually windows that you can look out of. Don't do anything with them. So, a mechanism. For some purpose. Should Selena press the button on the coffin lid? Yes? Selena presses the button and you hear scratching and banging inside the coffin. Suddenly the lid bursts open and the undead attack you. What, you both in there? Two ghouls. I'll wait here to see if this one comes up. Here we go. So we'll attack. Focus our attacks on this one. Nelvin's got points again. Spell points. So let's try some mudslings. And fail. Once I get his use magic up, and he gets some more spell points, so he's going to be a lot more useful. One of the worst things about Amber Star and Amber Moon, I guess, is failing spells and using mana anyway. There you go. 6 points. Helps. Throwing mud at him. I mean, imagine coming across a ghoul in a tomb and just throwing mud at it. That's the magical equivalent of what we're doing here. They're like not hitting us at all. Actually, they hit Edgel for a total of 8 points. I have a feeling that one to the left is almost dead, so... or inanimate. So I might as well fail on the other one. Boom! On your head. Flatten you with mud. Got some damage there. Yeah, thing's actually hitting me, can you believe that? I think he's out of spell points now. Yeah. I don't want to use up all these restore magic potions, so I'll just rest after this before we go on to the next room. She can pick that up. I'd rather her take the rest of these arrows. Okay, we don't have any regular arrows left for her. Just magical. I mean, that would help if she used them, because... start throwing away these short swords. Whee! So I can pick up other more valuable things. So now, chainmail, flail, and flail. So, did we accomplish anything here? Well, this is just to fight one of these things. And nothing happens now. Alright. Go rest in the corner, mostly just to get Melvin's spell points back. Having a blast with this game, loving it now. Four companions. Awesome. Oh, really? Would have no effect. Yeah, it would have the effect of us getting our spell points back, or his spell points back. I don't know how long we have to... wait around. Oh, really? Ridiculous. I want all his spell points back. Oh, you're kidding me! He has no food! Now we have to do it again. Rest. 5 rations, 9, 8. No, not drop food. Well, now is when we can conserve, because these guys don't need food right now. So if we give all the food to Nelvin, we won't use up food. That's... we can't even carry it. Well, he's got a lot of gold. So we don't waste food. Give it all to him. Temporarily, anyway. So 0, 0, 0. We never had to wait before resting, not in Amberstar. I don't know why they add this now. It kind of makes resting more irritating. An extra spell. An extra step. And it's silly to that. See, because we took the food away from them. Now he's got full hit points. So he rests next time. If we want any of them to regain anything, we'll have to remember to take the food off Nelvin. But yeah, it's silly how that message shows up and says there would be no effect. Of course there's going to be an effect. We're going to get our life points and or spell points back. Alright, so that was... interesting. We fought a couple ghouls. That's not what we were looking for. Alright, so back out into the next door. Is it this way? Lies behind door number two. Hey, Monstre! What? Banshees? Screaming like Banshee. Alright, we're gonna fight Banshees now. I'm sure they're gonna have some kind of a detrimental effect on us. He hits hard, so have Edge will just fight this guy, and the rest of us will fight the other one. I don't want to use the other spells because he uses up so much mana and he fails a lot. Let's see what these Banshees do to us. Mudsling failed. 7 points of damage. Attack Citrine and Selena. Attacking Selena is not good. I do not approve. Magical arrows. Okay. 2 points each, so our fighters here. I forgot to have him try Mudsling again. Irritate spell. I think we're alright. Boom! Keep an eye on Selena here. 98, 70. Magical arrows, 2 and 2. 11 points. On who? Me? That's... the messages fly by so quick, yeah. Nelvin. His robe is broken? Oh, he's dead. Are you kidding me? No. Alright. Am I back? I'm back here. I'm like, that's no good, his robe is broken, and then he's dead. Well, then the robe becomes the least of our problems. I'm wondering if maybe we should mess with the holy horn. You know what I'm gonna do? Magical shield. Fail. There we go. That should help. Maybe. Come on over here, big guy. Big guys. I should just focus on one, but I would lose two rounds moving myself over. Or moving him over. Holy horn. Fifteen charges of dispel undead. So I wonder if it makes them disappear, or run away, or actually causes damage on them. So I'm actually going to try that. Which monster will be your target? This one. Let's see, failed. Two and two. Oh! Wow! I hope we get experience for that. Actually, you don't have an ammunition. But you do have magical ammunition. You're moving over. Okay. Should be alright, just fighting one, as long as it doesn't decide to attack the priest. Kinda wouldn't make sense though, with us in the way. Not the priest, the mage. Wishful thinking, I wish we had a priest. Let's sing. Oof! Irritate spell. Nice, two in a row. He did 10 points of damage on Citrine, I guess. Yeah. I thought he was gonna get a third hit on it. That would have been awesome. Fail again. Boost chainmail? No, unacceptable. Crap. Wait. It was just regular chainmail, right? You're not equipped in combat. Well, that's not good. Back off. He's still attacking me. Why won't you let me put this stuff on? I have to use it again. Just hope we still get experience. I have three of these things, so it's a good deal. Oh! He made a critical hit before I could blow the horn. What? No good! Didn't have dead Citrine. Oh, these are kind of tough, aren't they? I did not cast my spell yet, so let's do that. Clicky. Come on. I know you're in here. How do you escape that? You can't escape a ranged attack. I could fly all the way to the end of the board and he would still be able to hit me, I think. But holy horn. If my chainmail shirt hadn't broken, that would have... That's what did it. Because I'm just wearing a regular chainmail shirt. If I was allowed to put on this one, that we got off one of the undeads, would have been just fine. Instead, then I was a sitting duck. Alright, so we're gonna destroy this one and focus on that one. Oof. You're attacking Agile, that's fine. Mud your eye. Irritate. Please, nothing break. I'd appreciate that very much if just nothing broke. Critical. Oh my god, what? Alright, screw it. Oh, I forgot something. Whatever. I'm just gonna use the horn twice. Go on, start attacking me. Poke. Hi. Talking to monster. Now you're in the door. It seems cheesy to do it this way. I wanted to fight them normally, but... I'll use the other Holy Horn and the other one next round, because I'm tired of attacking these things over and over. Hopefully you still get experience. We'll find out. In a moment. Experience. Alright. She's still got experience. Oh, that was interesting. Now we have two more of these things. Wait, this one is gonna have like 13 charges left. I'm glad anyone can use it, not just a paladin or something. We have another one here, which you haven't identified yet. Probably has another 15 charges. And then I think Edgel has one. Or maybe we left one behind in the house. Because we figured we already had one. Now we have another one. So we completely destroyed them, though. That means we can't pick up equipment. I realize that now. That was a button. Got a button. And another button over there. See, it's gonna open up something. Let's map out the room first before we even mess with the buttons. Because it might open something in this room and I want to see, you know, how it changes. Because right now, solid walls. Here and here. And there's nothing around the other way, right? I forgot to walk in here. Oh, this one of the other doors goes. I thought this was the door we came through now. This is... okay. That's interesting. Maybe we're supposed to go here last. I don't know. Maybe we will go there last. Episode 49, so... oop! Monstray, another door. Like the other side. Ah! Oh. Okay, another coffin. Map the room out. Not yet. Reminds me of the video from the police wrapped around your finger with all the candles. It's pretty much them performing. And I think it might be black and white. Can't remember for sure. And just candles all over. Pretty neat. Like really tall candles on stands. Alright. So we're gonna press the button. The monkey will press the button, and then the monkey will fight the undead. Yes. The undead attack you. Ghouls. Okay, much better than banshees. Oh, Salita's really hurt. I didn't even notice that. Oh, crap. Alright. I think Salita goes first anyway, so she'll use a potion herself. Mudsling here. You're attacking. Healing potion 2 should be sufficient for her. Have a lot of hit points. Didn't give her that much back. Gave her back 7 points. Oh, so I'll take another one then. Don't mind using these minor potions. Ow, 10 points. So she's at 24. I guess that's good enough. She just wonder if he has any tiny healing potions. No. I think one of us has some healing potions, one, or just one healing potion, one. Two. I'll just give it to her. Throwing a potion, catch! And we've got 4, 2, 3. Alright. Might as well tap herself off. She doesn't really have much effect in combat. Really keep her around for her lockpicking abilities. Okay, so you're attacking that one. I'm attacking that one. The ghoul's flail was broken. Ha ha. Would I give her, like, 3 points back? 2 points? Something like that. She's gonna be almost out of normal arrows. 14, or 15. Compared to the one in the notched, I guess. The other ghoul's flail is broken. So I guess now they're just punching us, I suppose. Yeah, they're just punching us. Alright. I don't want to use up the spell, whatever they're called, SP potions or whatever. So Nelvin will just hang out and watch. They've got to be pretty close to being defeated at this point. Poof! Yeah, there's a broken flails. Okay. So that's this room. The door. So back to these middle doors. Buttons to press. And it's really our only options left that I know of. Because we've been everywhere else. If I press these buttons, I'm assuming it will reveal two more doors or something like that. I want to rest up. We don't need much healing. 2 points there. Keep selecting that. He's got 21 rations. 2 here. 1 here. 2 here. The way around. Wait. Sleep. Get all his mana potions back. Or mana points back. Okay. So that'll be it. Next episode will be pressing these buttons and continuing on. Next episode will be a special 50th episode. So it's going to be an extra long episode. I don't know if we're going to finish the crypt, but either way, whether we do or not, it's going to be a 1 hour plus episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, guys, and always seek adventure.